everyone, I am Zui and I come from Malaysia. Today I'm going to introduce culture of Malaysia with the topic of festivals. But before I start, I would like to ask a question. Can you guess how many public holidays are there in Malaysia? 10? 12? 7? Well, I will show you the answer. This is the calendar of Malaysia. As you can see, there are 15 public holidays in a year. Yeah, you're right, 15. So honestly, I am very happy to be a Malaysian because there are so many public holidays. And I will show you an amazing data. As you can see, Malaysia has one of the highest number of public holidays in the world, ranking number 5 in the top 10 countries, after Thailand, China, Colombia, and India. So now you may ask me, why? Where are there so many public holidays in Malaysia? I will tell you that the answer lies on the culture of Malaysia. So in the coming section, I will introduce 3 main festivals in Malaysia, which are Islamic festivals, Chinese festivals, and Hinduist festivals. Malaysia actually is a unique country because of the multiracial and multi-religion society. There are three main populations in Malaysia, which are Malay, Chinese, and Indians. Even though Malaysia officially is a Muslim country, but the right of each religion is still free to practice in an atmosphere of acceptance and tolerance. So in the result, Malaysians celebrate many festivals together. So firstly, I would like to introduce Islamic festivals, which are Hari Raya Aidilfitri and Hari Raya Haji. During Hari Raya, the group of Malay will put on their traditional costume, just like the picture. For Chinese, we will have rice cake during Chinese New Year. While for Malay, they will have ketupat for their Hari Raya. In addition, they will host rumah terbuka, which means open house in English, to invite their friends to celebrate Hari Raya together in their houses. Now it comes to Chinese festivals. The group of Chinese in Malaysia celebrate Chinese New Year, Qingming festivals, Dragon Boat festival, Mooncat festivals, and so on, just like the Chinese in China and Taiwan. And we also have Tang Long. So I love to celebrate Chinese New Year in Malaysia because there are many lion dance performances everywhere. In addition, the practice of making rice dumpling and holding dragon boat race during the dragon boat festivals are still preserved in Malaysia. And now, I would like to introduce Hinduist festivals, which are Deepavali and Thai Busan. During Deepavali, you can find kolam in their houses, in Indians' houses. Kolam refers to a traditional floor art design which is made up of colorful rice. As you can see, this is one of the example of kolam, and you can even find it in shopping mall, and you can appreciate it during Deepavali. On the other hand, Indians will celebrate Thai Busam at Batu Cave in Malaysia. They will have to go up 272 stairs to get to the entrance of Batu Cave to pray for their god. In addition, some of the prayers will experience physical burden because they believe that it is granted protection against misfortune. And there is something that's very incredible. They will recover very soon after the celebration, because I think it's due to the protection of their god. Yeah. So these are the three main festivals celebrated in Malaysia, which are Islamic, Chinese, and Hinduist festivals. And there are Hari Raya, Hari Fitri, Chinese New Year, Diwali, and so on. Even though we all practice different culture and religion, but we all live together in harmony. So Malaysia is really a very good country. So any question? No? Thanks for listening today. Thank you.